one of the biggest conservative victories going back to the Margaret Thatcher days. That's pretty remarkable news from our standpoint. Simon Owen, how's it playing back there in London?
Hey, Aaron. Morning. Yes, busy 24, 36 hours here we've just had. And Boris Johnson, the returned Prime Minister, has just been speaking in Downing Street, addressing the nation and saying that his Conservative Party has won what he called an overwhelming mandate, not just to run the country, but specifically, he said, to complete Britain's proposed delayed divorce from the EU, the Brexit split. And Johnson said, we will honour that mandate by January the 31st. So we're looking at, after 3.5 years of all sorts of confusion and back and forth and debate about what Brexit should look like, if it should happen at all, it now looks like it's all going to happen pretty quickly, because Johnson has been returned to power with a majority of seats in the House of Commons, in Parliament, and a bigger majority, I think, than most people had expected. He's got a majority of 80 seats out of 650. That makes him pretty powerful. And so Brexit now seems to be speeding ahead.
Yeah, and President Trump kind of was already weighing in on this election as well. So I know he is fairly pleased with these election returns in the UK as well.
Yes, he sent his congratulations while the results were still being counted, but when it appeared pretty clear, well, almost entirely clear, that Boris Johnson had scored a big victory here. The president has stayed out largely of this election campaign. He was here in England last week, and reporters prodded him repeatedly to try and get his thoughts on the campaign and the election. You know, traditionally in diplomacy, foreign leaders stay out of another country's election, but President Trump is not traditional when it comes to diplomacy. And previously, he had torn strips off Boris Johnson's predecessor, Theresa May, and specifically her plans for Brexit. And so we understand there was a request from Boris Johnson for the president to stay out of the campaign, just to try and avoid, firstly, because the president is not very popular in the UK, but also in case there was some volatile, explosive intervention, they asked him to stay out of it. And he agreed to that. He gave a couple of fairly bland comments about liking Boris Johnson and liking the idea of Brexit, but he didn't get particularly involved. Well, today he has firstly sent his congratulations, but also said on Twitter that Britain and the United States will now be free to strike what he called a massive new trade deal after Brexit. So the president is seeing dollar signs as Boris Johnson closes in on this Brexit split.
Yeah, and that could be a remarkable news for us here in Montana and farm country, because as you and I talked about a year ago, when Theresa May was in some trouble, you know, we talked about what this could mean, what Brexit could mean, is the ability to set up bilateral trade deals instead of having to rely on the EU.
Yes, and this very much depends on who is in the White House, because during the Obama administration, there were warnings ahead of the Brexit vote that if Brexit happened, then Britain would not be getting any special treatment and would have to wait to strike a trade deal with the US. And that's concerning to a country that's about to, you know, cut a certain amount of ties with its closest trading partners in the EU, to be told that a close ally of the US wouldn't necessarily be in the mood to strike a quick trade deal. That is concerning. But all it takes is a change in the White House, and now you have President Trump. So while the Obama administration was pursuing a trade deal with the EU, with this block of countries, the Trump administration is much more keen on bilateral trade deals, so one country to one country. And so Brexit, for President Trump's politics, is very appealing. So they talk about a trade deal. Now, whether it is likely to be as quick as the president has suggested, I think that is questionable, because trade deals, by their nature, are traditionally lengthy endeavors. It can
take five, six, 7 years
to get these sort of things in line. Yeah, as you probably know, over where you are. So, you know, we'll see. But certainly there seems to be the offer there, if Boris Johnson decides to pursue it, of a deal.
All right. Well, Simon Owen, always appreciate your insights. Thanks so much for joining us here the day after the big elections from London. Always great to chat with you.
Thanks, Aaron.